It is directly telling us what it has seen inside of our Airtable. All right, so we got a significant upgrade to our dashboard. Look like we have successfully recorded new incident. What if you could just ask an AI, what are the latest records added to your Airtable? In this video, I'll show you how to connect Claude AI to your Airtable base using Zapier's new MCP feature. Stick around. Hi, this is Greg from Business Automated, and on this channel, we help you save time and money with useful solutions to automate your business. If you have not already, consider subscribing. That helps us produce more useful videos for you. Zapier has recently released their MCP feature, which allows you to connect thousands of the apps available inside of Zapier with your AI assistant. MCP stands for Model Context Protocol, which is a universal protocol allowing LLMs to access external tools. In this video, we'll use Zapier MCP to connect Claude to our hotel incident reporting database. To start, you have to go to zapier.com/mcp, as this will not be visible within your standard UI. Next step will be press Get Started, and here you will start creating new MCP server. The first question will be what kind of client you'll be using. In our case, we'll be using Claude. Create the MCP server. The next step will be what kind of tools we want to use. And you can see all tools that are available inside of Zapier. In our case, we'll use two tools. So we'll use Airtable Find Records and Airtable Create Records. Now for each of those tools, you can configure those actions. So you can go here to configure, and you can see that I have already Airtable account that is linked to Hotel Incident database. But if you would like to add a new connection, you can click here, connect new account, and select a base or multiple bases to connect to your MCP. In this case, it is better to have a dedicated connection which contains only single base to reduce the clutter for AI. So here, for the base that we'll be using here, we'll select a specific base. You can see that I can see only one specific base. For the tables, we let AI decide which tables it wants to use, but we'll let it know what are the options. Select value from one of those choices, and we'll provide the tables that are available. We'll also configure Find Records, and we'll specify what tables are available. And the remaining options we'll just leave to AI. All right, so we have configured what tools are available to our MCP server. The next step will be connecting this. So this is a unique link that you receive from Zapier, so you can copy the link. And here is the instruction how to operate it. So we'll go back to Claude and click Add Integrations. You can see that I already have here a custom Airtable integration. This is a custom MCP server that I have described in another video. So the video will be linked below so you can see it separately. But in this case, we'll just use Zapier. Here we're going to add the link. And now you can see we have a Zapier MCP server, and we're going to click Connect. This will open OAuth window, and this is how we will authenticate Claude to use Zapier. All right, so we have successfully connected Zapier. Let's start a new chat. So here at the bottom, you can access the tools, and you can disable individual tools available to the chatbot. All right, so we have Airtable Create Record and Find Records. So first, let's ask, what are the latest incidents that happened in our hotel in last week? And we will mention that the AI has access to Airtable through Zapier. And you will see that because we're making the first call, it is actually asking us whether we would be allowing it to make this specific call. And you can see that it also has added a formula here, which says that we are only looking for records that are after a specific date. In this case, we will do always allow, let's bite the bullet. And you can see that it's actually responding with exact details of all the incidents that have happened. And you can see that here we have business center, laptop theft. The next one is, let's say, refrigeration failure. So kitchen staff discovered a broken refrigerator unit. Next one, we have some guest injuries. So let's see if we can find this as well. So you can see it is directly telling us what it has seen inside of our Airtable. So it's giving us all the brief of everything that has happened. And also it gives us a recommendation what to do, what are the key trends. Now, talking about trends, let's see if it can make a dashboard showing what are the actual safety trends at our hotels. And basically, just like that, it starts writing code for, I'm guessing, a dashboard. Well, that seems... Wow, it was taking quite a while, but I think we have a pretty decent dashboard. This is looking pretty good. And we can actually stretch it a bit to have it bigger. And yeah, we have the trend. We have a list of incidents. We have estimated cost, number of high severity incidents, and so on. And it's actually taken the data from only last week. Let's see if we can add data for the full last month. You can see that it's looking for more records inside of Airtable to add the content here. So let's see what happens. And you can see that it's actually rewriting the code to add the additional information that it has retrieved from Airtable. And you can see that it looks like it might have cheated a little bit over here because it might have not added all the data rows here. All right, so we got a significant upgrade to our dashboard. So you can see that now we have comparison versus the previous month. I'm not convinced this is correct, but it looks significantly better. We also have some critical trends, some security concerns. I would say that probably it would make sense to kind of verify exactly what data it used, but if you give it to a developer, you definitely have a good starting point. And yeah, there is definitely something fishy happening on Friday. Yeah, so this is pretty impressive. Let's see whether it works. Oh, actually, it actually does a console log about filtering for different different times for different time ranges and so on, but it doesn't seem to be doing anything. But anyway, that's a great start. You could actually also publish this and share with someone as a reference of what it would look like. You could also give it comments for sure to adjust the colors and style and so on. But okay, so let's try one more final thing. So let's create actually a new incident. Let's report new incident. And let's pick a hotel. A guest says that they have lost their phone at the dinner and it must have been the waiter. And let's use one of the employees to report it. Let's say we'll take Olivia. And now it's actually creating a record. Likely the API has returned with some errors because it didn't know the proper record ID of the linked property, so it couldn't create the record. So you can see that it's actually used the find records to find the record ID for that specific property. And you can see that it's also missing some additional information over here. So it's making additional requests to find the right data, but it's also making a broader request to make sure that it finds the right category for the incident. Look like we have successfully recorded new incident. Here there are some more details, but let's see whether this is really in our Airtable. Yes, it is. It has not added the incident reference, but it has selected the right category, the right incident type, severity, new item, then the right location, guest reports missing phone. This is not bad. We know the staff involved and so on. Okay, this is pretty impressive. And it also marked it as requiring a follow-up. So we know by who it was reported, 201. So this was the ID of Olivia Thompson. This is correct. All right. So this is pretty impressive. You have just created a record inside of your Airtable and and did some data analysis using Claude and using Zapier MCP. So this is just connecting Airtable, but there are so many other applications that you could connect here. So this is just the starter for your automation needs. Let us know how you like it, what ideas you have. And as always, thank you very much for your time and good luck automating your business.